What's up, guys? It's Jet from Imperium Racing. Today, we're going to be replacing the right side axle on my 2001 Lifted Miata. Boom. Now, I already got things started, put it up on a jack stand, pulled that wheel off. Cool thing about lifting a Miata is you got all the suspension stuff pretty much at the limit of its travel, so you can see this 19-year-old boot tore itself and has been shooting all the grease out, and it's finally making so many violent noises that I decided it's probably time to replace it before it blows up when we're off-road or on the freeway. Got my replacement over here. It's from a pick and pull, so it's super, super rusty. So it's been soaking in some penetrant spray, some rust penetrant. It's from a 99. This car is an 01. First thing I found out is that, ignore these really cheap wheel spacers, the threads that hold the axle nut on the 99 are smaller. So I compared it to the other side. They're the same in every other way. It should fit in just the same as stock, but gonna have to go back to the part store, get a 99 one of this. What project's right if you don't mess up at least one part run, right? Let's get going. Already did myself the favor of soaking the nut here, and the backside of this as much as you can reach in there with some PB Blaster rust penetrant stuff. The Miatas are notorious for having these things seize in place, so it could be a pretty fun adventure pulling it off, but let's find out. So the axle nut is in American a 1 1/4, whatever that relates to in metric. You can smack out the little center punch, but we're gonna try to just ugga-dugga it off with an impact. And that's not going to work. So, gotta get a punch. So, if you don't know, when you put an axle nut on, it has a little ring around the top and an indent on the axle itself. So you actually punch the nut into that piece so it can't back off. With a really strong impact, it'll take it off no problem. We're using my dad's one from probably the 80s. So any little punch that'll fit in that hole and a hammer will do the trick just fine. So I got that punched out nice and round. Hopefully the impact will take it off now. And it didn't. All right, drastic measures. If anything's gonna do it, a 2-foot breaker bar is gonna do it. And there it is. No problem. Now, the real issue is the spline sitting in there will seize to the hub. Another big move is to get a much bigger, this is like a little pointy guy, a punch that fills this whole space. Or you can wind your old nut back on a little bit and take a hammer to it. Because I'm lazy and don't want to take these off, we're going to find a punch that will fill this space better and just go to town until you can see if you can back that thing out. All right, I didn't film this because I knew it would take forever and we're on to drastic measures. So here's where we're at. Smacking it with a little punch, big punch, really big hammer, did not work. So I pulled the spacer off, put the axle nut back on, and was just smashing that with the sledgehammer. You can see that is obliterated, has not budged. So drastic measure is gonna be taking the caliper off, taking the rotor off. We're gonna use this puller pusher guy to grab onto the hub and hopefully press the axle out. Let's get to it. All right, caliper is held on by these two 14 mil bolts right here. I already got them pretty much off. Super surprising, they were not stuck on at all. So, gonna get these two off. And if you're lucky and your parking brake's not on, caliper should slide right off, which it did. And now the rotor should do the same. Their rotors can be seized on, but so much PB Blaster was put into this thing and so much hammering, it broke loose all on its own. All right, so if you don't have one of these at home, you can usually rent something like it at an AutoZone or an O'Reilly or something like that. It just clips on back of the hub. Make sure you don't have it on your wheel studs. And we're gonna put this impact to it and pray we don't die. Using manpower. that's looking real sketch.
Whew. All right, so for anybody who knows, taking a Miata axle off can be a huge pain in the ass. And this one is gonna be. So we're on to drastic measures. I put as much pressure on this guy as I thought was feasibly possible. Could not turn this thing without feeling like I was gonna break something. We're gonna take the entire hub off with the axle. So that's not a lot harder. This car had ABS, so the center's still there. There's a 10 mil bolt there and two 10 mils here and there. Pull that thing right off. Top control arm bolt, 14 millimeters both sides, took the nut off that side. Long bolt on bottom, 17 on this side, 21 on that side. So now we're gonna take trusty hammer and use a jack to lift the suspension up just a little bit. Take some of the pressure off. Now that that's loose, might not even need the hammer. Yep, don't need it. This will pop out. A little bit of force. Now the top half is free to come out. And that's gonna give us enough room to get a pry bar behind the axle and pop it out. I'm gonna have a really hard time filming this part, so I'm kinda gonna explain it on the new one. These axles are just held in with this big round C-clip into the diff. There's no bolts. Any means necessary, you find the biggest pry bar you can, get behind this green piece, between the green piece and the diff, and just pry an insane amount. And most of the time, it doesn't come out very easily. And when it does come out, it's gonna launch the damn thing out. So that's why I'm keeping the one bottom bolt on this. That way, when it does launch this entire assembly out, I don't launch the entire hub and everything across the driveway and down the hill into space. All right, so here we are on the ground. I've got the brake caliper kind of strung up out of the way. That way when this pops out, it won't smack anything. The tiny little space we have to pry is kind of against this little lip. I have this little cannon brace on the back that I'm gonna try to use as a wedge to crank it out. And we're just using a big old crowbar. And we're gonna see what happens. All right, update. So I use this pry bar and the hammer on the end of it to get that little gap you can see right there. There's usually no gap where this crowbar is. It's a millimeter, now it's a couple. So now that gap, we're gonna stick the crowbar in there, see if we can pop it out. And it's worth noting, I forgot to mention, don't throw any PB Blaster or rust penetrant in there because there is a seal there that you shouldn't have to replace unless it's leaking. And you don't wanna hit it with a bunch of PB Blaster or stuff like that. All right, so that worked. There it is, popped out. There's that destroyed boot. And now we can just take this guy off and pull this entire assembly out and deal with it as a whole. So things went from extreme and drastic to extra extreme, extra drastic. We have the piece out. She's sitting over here. There's the hub attached. There's the destroyed boot. She's not very happy. Now we're gonna have to find crazy means to get this out of this, hopefully on a bench. Another good thing to note about these beautiful little cars is Big Boy Supreme that sits right there. You can see it's nice and orange and rusty in the center. It welds itself to the hub right here. The top one will come out no problem, that little 14 up here, but it gets welded to this. So you have to crack it loose by spinning the head. I had to use the 2 foot breaker bar, this guy right here, to spin the head sitting over here. And then once it gets to about there, it binds sideways, gets locked up. Had to get extra crazy with a couple different punches. I think this guy finally did the trick to work it out. There's the diff. I'm not gonna replace that seal. And even better news, this new guy, parts store told me it was from a 99, the dismantlers I should say, is from a 97. So this size is a lot harder to find for whatever reason. I called up the parts stores. I said the closest one they can get to me to get an axle nut for that is in Portland, Oregon. We're here close to Sacramento, California. So it sucks, and baby's gonna have to sit here for a couple days like this. To be continued. All right, day two of the very easy Miata axle install. We've moved up to the three-piece puller on the vise here. And still not working. We've used heat, which is pretty much useless from that gun. We were gonna put a torch to it, but we don't wanna roast the bearing in there. So I'm gonna do what I didn't wanna have to do, but called up the local machine shop. They have a hydraulic press. We're gonna drop it off, see if they can press it out. I know this is supposed to be a do-it-yourself video, but A lot of these axles end up like this, so if you have to do that too, it's a viable option. Most machine shops, auto repair shops will have a hydraulic press. This is a pretty tricky piece to line up in a press, so we're gonna drop it off and see if they can do it. They can't, pretty much out of options, but it's kind of a bummer because we wanted to get the Adventure Miata ready to enjoy the start of this weather. Play around in the snow. It's supposed to start snowing more today, and not gonna get very far with this thing in pieces. Gonna drop it off at the machine shop in a few hours, see how it goes. All right, day three of the axle DIY. And this is the weather we're working with today. So I didn't film a lot today because I mostly just wanted to avoid the weather. It's supposed to start snowing again pretty soon. Got 4 or 5 inches last night. I had the local machine shop press the old axle out of the hub. This is the new one. The axle nut's still on the way, so it's just sitting in there for now. Just wanted to get this thing out of the middle of the driveway so we can clear it and get the Jeep out of here. Took him a few attempts and 40,000 pounds of pressure on a hydraulic press to get that out. Not a lot to see from here. You smack the old one in, you make sure it gets flush against the diff like the old one was. You press it into the knuckle as far as you can. It shouldn't take that much effort. You should just PB blaster everything and it should push right in. Everything goes back together relatively easy from there. When I get that final axle nut, I'm gonna take the wheel back off and I'll do the torque specs on everything. I'm literally just pulling this thing out of the way right now. We'll talk more then. All right, it's day 4, 5 of the world's worst DIY axle install on a Miata. Here we go, everything's actually finally back together. In all honesty, I wanted to put some miles on it before I told anybody that you can actually put a 97 axle into an 01 car with no issues, and you can. Got the rear axle nut right there. That one was a little bit tricky because, again, it's a 97 axle 01 car. Torque specs between the years were from like 130 to 180. I just did 150. Should be fine. Then this guy right here, you do 44 foot-pounds. They said 50 for the big guy that I replaced down here. It goes all the way across the rear knuckle. I do like 65 just because 50 seems small for something so big. And then the caliper mounting bolts there and there, you do 27 foot-pounds. Anything like this, especially with these older cars, it's a good idea to drive it a little bit, then maybe check them again after 100 miles or so. You don't have to, but better safe than sorry. But yeah, I put about 120 miles on this thing and everything seems fine. The new axle bolt has not, or I'm sorry, axle boot has not torn yet. You can see the diff is leaking a bunch though, and resealing the diff and replacing the seals is gonna come in a later video when we hopefully weld the diff. That'll do for now. So thanks for tuning in. And watching the world's worst DIY on replacing an axle on a Miata. Oh yeah.
Peace.
Look at that.